in the context of at least studying the internet and the analytics and data that come out of the internet, people can well articulate why it works for them and why it matters to them. As we've looked more deeply into the future, say looking out over the next 10 to 15 years, these experts sounded a number of themes. And positive themes about what would happen. So they argued that information sharing over the internet would be effortlessly interwoven into daily life. It'll make people smarter, safer, and more efficient. And I imagine that lots of you listening to this are in the business of fulfilling those goals. One of the analysts used the word computation, which is essentially communication via data. And he was talking about involving smart agents. So our smart agents will be dealing with each other and we'll be able to outsource lots of the logistics and sort of silly time-consuming parts of our life to agents that might help us plan our lives. So that's one theme they sounded. They talked about the sort of broad awareness that people will have of their world and their own behavior. And that the benefits would come from this, especially for improved healthcare. A lot of talk about personalized medicine, a lot of talk about population level studies that might give you insights into disease outbreaks and treatments, and a lot of talk about education. You know, healthcare and education have been two areas where the applications of technology have been pretty narrow. You know, if you look at the way technology has changed the news business and the publishing business and so many other businesses, there has not been the same level of dramatic change in healthcare and education, but these experts say that especially in the age of data, the transformation of healthcare and the transformation of education will be incredible things to behold and will bring very tangible benefits to people's lives. They also talk about, you know, smart structures and smart supply systems themselves. You know, and as the environment gets more intelligent, a lot of talk about smart homes, smart communities, smart environments around us. And I'm sure a lot of you are working on systems and structures that will, tell us when problems are arising before they really get serious. Tell us when we can make our lives more efficient and safe. Tell us when we're in trouble and we need to get help. So there are lots of ways that these analytics will play into us. I'll just do a real quick run through the dark sides because they give voice to them too. They're worried about privacy, as the way the general public is. They're worried about the impact of a lot of analytics work and artificial intelligence on impinging into jobs that people are paid for now, and what might that do to labor markets and the sort of broad cultural expectations there are about people being gainfully employed and finding meaning in their life that way. They're worried about increased digital divides related to people mastering the technology and moving far ahead of their fellow citizens, not at the same pace, and that's just a breeding ground for resentment and possible violence. And that's a big thing that they worry about. Of course, anytime you bring up technology and a top of mind concern is everything getting hacked. And finally, talk about sort of human nature and how it's abused by all the new technologies that are coming out. And they think that, the darker sides of human nature get amplified and accelerated by some of the changes that are out there. And that's very much on their mind.